Hello anatomy colleagues, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing the muscles of the medial compartment of the thigh. And as I assume you're getting used to, we will be discussing, of course, the major muscles with innervation, attachments, and you can't forget the actions of these muscles. So as you might imagine, the medial compartment is located in the medial portion of the thigh, and portions of it actually can be seen in the anterior view as well. So this is kind of showing a closer up view with a deeper dissection, but you can see a few of these muscles from this anterior view as well. There are five major muscles. There are the three adductor muscles. Adductor longus to me is tied with gracilis, one of the easiest to locate. As it is large, it's fan-shaped muscle, it's more anteriorly placed. So it's one of the more prominent ones that you can see, particularly from an anterior view. Locating adductor brevis takes a bit more dissection as it is deep to the adductor longus for some of its portion as well. So you can see it right here is the adductor brevis, but it's also deep to the pectineus muscle, which has been removed here. So if you're looking at a straight anterior view, as you can see here without any deeper dissection, it's really not visible. The adductor magnus, as you might suspect, is the largest adductor muscle. And it's actually composed of two parts. There is the adductor part, which is the larger part. And really the bulk of the adductor magnus is going to be that part. You can see a little of it here and a little of it here. But there's actually another portion that's often referred to as the hamstring part. And that's more closely associated, both in terms of actions and innervation, to the hamstring muscles in the posterior thigh. It's often hard to differentiate the two when you're looking at it in a dissection. The adductor magnus as a whole is actually quite posterior medially placed, which makes sense that some of that larger bulk that comes with this muscle would kind of head back more posteriorly and not further medially to kind of reduce the bulk in that region. But oftentimes you can see a little bit of it from this anterior view. Another muscle I find on the easier side to locate or to identify is the gracilis muscle, as it is relatively superficial and it's the most medial muscle in this compartment. So you can see a bit of it right here. It will continue down all the way, even actually to the tibia. And it just looks like a long strap running along the medial border. The obturator externus is also usually included with the medial compartment, but as its actions don't totally align with this compartment, we are going to mention it here and move on. So that is why it is not bolded. The majority of the muscles in this compartment are innervated by the obturator nerve. You can see that here coming off of the lumbar plexus, similar to the femoral nerve. So both are branches of the lumbar plexus. And this is another notable compartment that is not being innervated by the sciatic nerve, except for that hamstring part of the adductor magnus, which is innervated by the sciatic nerve, specifically the tibial part of the sciatic nerve. The tibial part or tibial nerve is one of its two terminal branches. And this is actually the same innervation that we will see when we get to the rest of the hamstring. So that'll be our next learning objective. But 4.5 of the other muscles, 4.5 out of 5 muscles are innervated by the obturator nerve. So definitely the predominant supply to this compartment. The obturator nerve actually splits into two parts around the adductor brevis. So you can see the adductor brevis here, and you can see this little nerve traveling over. That would be the anterior portion. And then the deeper, or on the deep surface of the adductor brevis, you would see the posterior compartment, and that's going to send branches. All the muscles mentioned in this compartment have a proximal attachment somewhere on the inferior portions of the coxal bones. And then, as you might imagine, they're going to cross the hip joint region, thus being able to affect action there. The adductor muscles, so the longus, brevis, and magnus, have some level of distal attachment on the linea aspera of the posterior femur. So this is an anterior view here, and you can kind of get an understanding that these are attaching on the posterior side of the femur. And you can see on this just osteological portion, the linea aspera is this rather long line running down the posterior portion of the body or the shaft of the posterior femur. And so the different adductor muscles will attach along the extent of the linea aspera. Of note, the gracilis muscle actually additionally crosses the knee joint. So most of these don't make its way to the knee joint, but the gracilis does, and it has an attachment on the tibia. But gracilis is a relatively weak muscle, so only providing synergistic actions to the knee. Lastly, we can't forget actions. This is a pretty easy one too. So the adductor or medial compartment of the thigh will primarily adduct the hip joint. So adduction is key here, which is pulling the thigh medially towards or even past the median plane. So moving it in this direction. I always conceptualize this compartment and think of getting on a horse, and you instinctively adduct your thighs or kind of try to pull them closer to the median plane in order to lock yourself on that horse to keep yourself from falling. So think about that kind of action that can occur there. In fact, individuals who competitively ride horses often have very prominent linea aspera and hypertrophied adductor muscles because of that repetitive action. The hamstring part of the adductor magnus always has to be the odd one out, and once you learn the specifics of the posterior compartment of the thigh, you can lump that part in with that. But this hamstring part of the adductor magnus will assist the hamstrings in extension of the hip joint. Excellent. Thank you for all your time and attention here. And please do feel free to reach out with any questions. Have a great rest of your day.